Blaine, can you start off by telling me a little bit about your very varied research and how you got into that particular area of research?
It's a bit of a long story, I guess. I got into computer science because I like playing with toys. And I tell everyone that I've got the best job in the world because other people pay for my toys. And that led me really to look at the more technical side and things that led me to look at computer forensics, digital forensics, and studying ways in which we can investigate what people are doing with their computers and find evidence of crimes and things like that.
So in terms of these new technologies, is there a particular area of research that you're working on at the moment?
Yes. So when I went on from the digital forensics work, we started looking at privacy, because that's the sort of flip side, how to keep yourself protected from prying eyes. And in the current research, what we're doing is looking at social media, Facebook in particular. There are certain problems where people are harassed or bullied online. And in order to have that crime investigated, they have to go to the police. And it's quite a long process of explaining to police what the problem is and maybe taking screenshots and being interviewed and so on. And what we've done is built a tool that allows people to find the evidence themselves in their Facebook timeline and prepare it in a way that's what we call forensically sound. And that means that it would stand up in court. It's collected in a way that you can prove the authenticity of it. And what this does is save the police time, because they don't have to send officers around interviewing people. And it has the advantage of letting people maintain their privacy, because what they can do is do it in the privacy of their own home. If they're a victim of a crime, quite a sensitive crime perhaps, they don't want to do that in front of other people. So it allows the victim to, in their own time, take their Facebook timeline, redact out the things that really aren't relevant for the police, maybe the holiday snaps or conversations with a lover or whatever. And that means that they can just present the information that is just required. It saves the police time. They don't have to go through the long timeline. They get exactly what they need and then can decide how to prosecute the crime or not.
So this is something that they can do themselves at home, and they can just pick out the evidence that they want the police to see and keep the rest of their online lives private.
Exactly. You can redact the things that are unimportant, and that does two things. That preserves your privacy, so they don't get to see your conversations with your lover. It also saves the police time, because they don't have to waste their time going through weeks of data that is irrelevant to their investigation. And it's forensically sound, which means that we lock it in a way that shows the court that nothing has been changed. You couldn't have added in a fake conversation, for example.
So have you had any feedback from the police on this particular area?
Yes, we've been working with the Gwent police in Wales, who particularly approached us because they get a lot of Facebook-related harassment cases. And they see this as a huge time saver, because they have to send officers physically to go and investigate, visit victims, take statements, record screenshots, and so on. And in this case, the people do all the footwork themselves, and the evidence comes in electronically. No one has to even leave their home.
So this research is going to have a genuine impact for both on the police side and also on the victim side.
Yes, we expect it to save police time, but also allow more victims to come forward, because they don't have the embarrassment of showing up at a police station or talking about their intimate private life in front of strangers.
So that's a really broad area of research. How does that feed into the teaching that you do?
In two ways. I still lead the digital forensics module, and social media has changed radically since I started this module nearly 10 years ago. So we feed back the research we get on social media crimes back into the teaching, so people can learn how to investigate them. And we also have a cybersecurity MOOC, Massive Online Open Course, which is an introduction to all the techniques you can use to protect yourself, many of which we get from the research we do in both this kind of forensics and other forms of cybersecurity.
It's been really great to hear about that big spectrum of research, Blaine, but what I'm most impressed with, it's about how it has a real impact on people's lives.
Yeah, that's the nice thing, is that we're the part of computer science that lets us get to real people and find out what real people do in the real world.